experience buy with AtlasRVStore.com, and we're here at the Alien booth at RV Journal Live 2016 with Terry Pruitt. How are you doing this year?
I'm doing just fine.
Doing good? Okay, well, you look great, and we're here at the Alien booth again from a couple years ago. He has some new products to show us. I think we might start with the F800. Does that sound good with you?
That sounds good for me. We are bringing out three brand new products.
Okay.
It's been a while since we brought out a new reader product. We're bringing out new fixed reader product and new handheld reader product.
Okay.
And both of them are not just incremental improvements. They're actual game changers.
Oh, wow.
Right? Both from a price and a performance standpoint. Okay. So let's get right to it.
All right, that sounds good. And they're actually releasing that handheld at the show, right? So this is the first time it's been out.
This is the first time that it's been out.
So an exclusive.
This is the world premiere. It's the F800. It's our new high-end reader. It's a four-port reader. It is at the top of the charts in terms of both output power and read sensitivity. For example, most of the readers at the high end in RFID in PoE mode, when they're using power over Ethernet, they only output 28 or 29 dB.
Right.
We're at 31.5.
Oh, wow.
Okay. So we get plenty of output power. It operates as well in PoE as it would coming out of a wall.
Okay.
The best thing about the reader is that it has massive processing power and massive memory. What this allows is for an integrator to load complex algorithms on the reader and also full applications on the reader and actually use the reader as an edgeware computer.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So you can eliminate huge amounts of hardware, you can eliminate programming stacks, you can eliminate software stacks by utilizing this reader. You can actually make your implementations more efficient.
And have the middleware that you would have if you didn't have this reader actually on the reader. Wonderful.
Yeah.
That's absolutely great.
And in terms of connectivity, it's at the top of the charts as well.
Okay.
Because you have two, not one, but two USB ports.
Oh, okay.
So the one USB port is used for a connectivity like dongles, wireless dongles, or cellular,
right,
things of that nature. And the other one is used like a serial port for diagnostics and configuration and things of that nature. We also actually have a serial port on the reader.
Okay.
So because a lot of our partners, and this was designed with our partners in mind, a lot of our partners still like to use serial communication do the configuration of the reader and diagnose any problems or anomalies that might happen. Right,
right? Definitely.
It
diagnostics
has,
are important.
Correct, absolutely.
Yes.
Although our readers never actually need to be diagnosed because they never break down.
Exactly.
Of course.
I mean, we gotta say that before we even go any further.
Yes, that's the disclaimer.
Disclaimer.
Right.
By Terry.
We also have a GPIO that's four circuits in and eight circuits out that allows you to drive other devices.
Okay.
Gates, light stacks, that type of thing.
Okay? Right.
So that is the F800. And the key thing, though, I said price as well as performance.
Right.
Normally, a high-end reader like that in the industry today is running anywhere between $1,700 and $2,199 list.
Right. Right.
This one has a list price of $1,399.
Yeah, so it's a great price point for what you get, and it's a small form factor too.
Very small form factor, very ergonomic. The portal manufacturers really love it because they can save space.
Yeah.
So we think it's a game changer, and the beginning results, that the feedback that we're getting from our partners in the field and also from the end users is exceptional.
Great. That's awesome.
So we're very happy. We think it will be by June of this year. We're filming this in May, right?
May, yes.
We think that by the end of June, at run rate, it'll be the biggest selling reader in RFID.
Well, awesome. I mean, you obviously have a winner here with that power, small form factor, performance.
We feel like it's an integrator's reader. This reader was designed by the gentleman, Mark McDonald, who at one time ran our field application engineering division.
Okay. Yeah.
And so he spent most of his time communicating with our partners about what they wanted and what they didn't want in a reader.
Right.
And on top of that, he and his team had more implementation experience in RFID than any other team in this industry.
Right.
And
definitely.
So they took all of that knowledge and they put it into that little black box. Okay?
Yes.
And so it is, what we call it is the integrator's reader. It's
awesome.
A reader that it was made for the ease of use, for the ease of implementation, and the efficiency of implementation of the integrator.
Awesome.
Right?
Well, it's a great reader, and I know we've sold quite a few on our website already, so I can't wait to sell more and start selling the new handheld as well.
Now, Alien went to great expense at this show.
Okay.
To make sure that we staged our new handheld in a really dramatic way. So we went out and hired an intern to stand behind this wall and stick his hand through the wall and hold the reader for the entire show.
And he doesn't move.
And he does not move.
Yeah.
He's like the best mime you've ever seen, right? So I can do anything. I can tickle his hand. I can like touch
yes.
it, and he never even flinches.
He has but some slow reflexes.
But the important
that.
Thing, thanks Butch. The important thing is this. This is the new Alien ALH H450
okay.
handheld reader. This is an Android handheld.
Okay.
It's based on an Android KitKat base, open source. So Android programs should load on here seamlessly. Now this is the reader that is, as much as the F800 is a game changer, this one is really a game changer.
For the handheld industry especially.
For the handheld
yeah.
industry. Now this includes not only RFID, and by
yeah.
the way, this RFID engine in here
yeah.
is what we call a flamethrower.
Oh.
Meaning that it our early beta testers have been reading tags from anywhere from 28 to 32 feet away.
Oh, wow.
Now, normally that's like 20 feet.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So we're getting incredible read range from this thing. Very powerful Alien circular antenna. So
awesome.
A circular antenna, as we learned the last time you filmed me, is important because if it's a linear antenna, then you have to turn the reader to meet the orientation of the tag.
Exactly.
In this one, all you do is point and shoot.
Point and shoot.
Point
and
shoot.
Do.
So it's got the RFID reader.
Right.
It also has both 1 and 2D barcode scanning. It also has Bluetooth. It also has GPS. It's a 3G device. And it includes the battery in the handle and the battery up inside the reader. And all Alien handheld readers come with the power supply and the charging and data cradle.
So it's all in one, basically.
All in
one. You don't have to buy
anything
else.
Everything that you need to begin scanning tags and operating the system, you can do
right.
with
just purchasing that one purchase price.
Just that one purchase price. Normally, for that feature set in this
yeah.
industry, you're paying anywhere between $36.95 and $42.95.
Right.
And that's 1,000. $4,295, $36.95. Our reader, our Windows Mobile version of this reader,
yeah.
is $39.95. Okay?
Okay?
The list price of the H450 is $15.99.
Oh my gosh, no way.
It is. Way.
Well, to imagine that it's a reader and an antenna in one, circularly polarized antenna, that is an amazing
yeah,
price.
It is it's a great price. Let's put that into implementation terms, okay? If you're out there and you're specking out a 50-unit deal for a branch of the government, Homeland Security, or the DLA, or maybe you're specking something out for an automobile manufacturer or a retailer, and
right.
it's going to be a 50-reader deal.
Right.
If they were considering using a $39.95 reader, which is basically the price point everybody is at,
right.
and instead they spec in this, on a 50-reader deal, they're basically saving over $100,000 at list.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Okay? So what that does is it actually makes the project happen.
Yes.
It makes the ROI happen.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
It increases the entire attractiveness
of the project, of implementing RFID in
yes.
general. Right.
So anybody that was considering a handheld and had developed an Android program
right.
and is going out on a big bid,
yeah.
if they're not using the H450, they will be drooling the drool of regret on the pillowcase of remorse.
Oh.
and you don't want that to happen.
That sounds horrible.
It is horrible,
it
isn't
it? Horrible,
right,
yeah.
Butch? There you go, brother.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
yeah, he's there.
He's there.
And it's a great reader. I mean, from all I've seen, I saw the data sheet earlier, yeah. And it looked like it just has everything that you need in a price point that you honestly wouldn't expect from a handheld RFID reader.
No, you wouldn't. There's no other unitary design reader that is at this price point.
Exactly.
Normally, what this would be competing against are sleds, where people have connected a cell phone to an RFID apparatus.
Right.
But there are connectivity issues with that.
Right.
There are issues with using people's personal cell phones.
Exactly.
There's all sorts of little things that people are finding out. This is a unitary design that people are used to using. There's
right.
no learning curve.
Right.
You go into a retailer, people have been scanning barcodes forever.
Right, right? Exactly.
But with this, they don't have to do anything different than they've ever done before, except it's easier. Instead of pulling out the tag and scanning one at a time,
right.
they're just sitting there pointing, drinking coffee, pointing.
Exactly. Your morning warm-up, right?
Or Diet Coke in your case.
Diet Coke, yes, in my case.
That's
yes,
right.
Definitely. Definitely. Well, I mean, I love the reader. That looks awesome. The F800 is awesome as well.
Yeah.
So you want to take us through some of the tag, the new tag that you
well,
have?
The main thing that we're... Alien is the only company in the industry that manufactures the tag ICs, which is the little chip that's the brains of a tag.
Right.
We also manufacture the full inlay that
right.
the IC goes on to. So we actually manufacture the full RFID inlay,
right.
as well as the readers.
Exactly.
So we're the only one with a complete solution, right?
Right.
And we're really proud of our new HIGGS-EC chip. Now, the benefit of the HIGGS-EC
yes.
is that it is faster and more sensitive in both writing to the tag and reading the tag.
Right.
It's at the top of the industry in terms of the standards there.
And I know that's important because we get a lot of questions that's like, okay, do I use the HIGGS 3 or the HIGGS 4? So now there's even, you know,
yeah.
one more. So it's like what HIGGS, is the
HIGGS
difference?
4, like the HIGGS 4, it is 128-bit EPC code plus a 128 user bit.
Okay.
And of course it has all of our security features, the, mm-hmm. the dynamic authentication, the
right.
Unique code, the TID. In addition, it has, the EC stands for error correction. It rarely happens, but when it does happen, it's a real problem.
Yes.
There are what are called bit flipping errors, where one of
okay.
the bits will actually change its value. And it usually happens if a chip has gotten crushed
okay.
in production.
Yeah.
But it can also happen for other reasons as well.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen very often. We're an incredibly reliable industry.
That's true,
okay?
yes.
But when it does happen, it's a problem for the entire supply chain,
mm-hmm.
right? And the entire process.
Right.
HIGGS EC was built to automatically correct bit flipping errors.
Really?
Okay, there's an algorithm and logic within the chip that allows you to do that. So it is something that has performance advantages, it has usability advantages, and eventually pricing advantages, because it has factors that allow us to be far more efficient in terms mm-hmm. of the way we manufacture it.
Okay.
We can put more of these chips on a wafer than any other chip in the industry.
Oh, wow.
So
yeah.
that makes the whole manufacturing process, the process of breaking down that wafer, taking the individual chips, placing them on the inlay,
right.
it makes that entire process far more efficient
right.
and time effective.
So you can offer it a better price.
And so the costing goes down, and eventually that translates into lower user price, which is good for the entire industry.
Exactly. And so what are there any form factors that we can purchase now that y'all have already available? Or
yes. The form factors that you see here, which is our high scan, our garment tag, our squiglet, and our squiggle tag, they've all been manufactured and they're in the process of being approved by the University of Auburn. Also, we're going to be adding our other SKUs as well.
Oh, great, okay.
This is going to be our new standard chip. We're keeping the HIGGS 3 because it has the expanded memory.
Okay.
You recall, the HIGGS 3 is 96-bit EPC and 512 user bits of
Wait,
memory.
Which is like one of the biggest user bits of
yeah.
memory that
and,
you can
And for specialty markets,
yeah.
open road tolling or
right.
anything very specific to a specific industry where they need more data or
right.
more security,
right.
the HIGGS 3 still is an incredibly viable tag with great performance aspects.
Right.
But the HIGGS-EC for the volume business, retail apparel,
mm-hmm.
pharmaceuticals, anything that where you're really focused on that unique serial number,
right.
the HIGGS-EC is going to be the tag going forward.
Well, that's awesome, because if somebody has already found a tag that they really like, they can know that that tag is going to be manufactured with the new EC, with the new IC in it. So they can purchase that, you know, if you already love the squiggle and you want the squiggle and you don't need a lot of memory, the EC, the IC is ready right now with the tag. And then if you need other ones, it'll soon be manufactured as well. Correct. So that's great. Memory.